And now, a message from the Queen to the citizens of the United States of America from Her Sovereign Majesty Queen Elizabeth II. In light of your failure in recent years to nominate competent candidates for President of the USA and thus to govern yourselves, we hereby give notice of the revocation of your independence, effective immediately. You should look up revocation in the Oxford English Dictionary. Her Sovereign Majesty Queen Elizabeth II will resume monarchical duties over all states, commonwealths, and territories, except North Dakota, which she does not fancy. Your new Prime Minister, David Cameron, will appoint a governor for America without the need for further elections. Congress and Senate will be disbanded. A questionnaire may be circulated next year to determine whether any of you noticed. To aid the transition to British Crown dependency, the following rules are introduced with immediate effect. Number 1. The letter U will be reinstated in words such as color, favor, labor, and neighbor. Likewise, you will learn to spell donut without skipping half the letters, and the suffix I-Z-E will be replaced by the suffix I-S-E. Generally, you will be expected to raise your vocabulary to acceptable levels. Look up vocabulary. Number 2. Using the same 27 words interspersed with filler noises such as like and you know is an unacceptable inefficient form of communication. There is no such thing as U.S. English. We will let Microsoft know on your behalf. The Microsoft spell checker will be adjusted to take into account the reinstated letter U and the elimination of I-Z-E. Number 3. July 4th will no longer be celebrated as a holiday. Number 4. You will learn to resolve personal issues without using guns, lawyers, or therapists. The fact that you need so many lawyers and therapists shows that you are not quite ready to be independent. Guns should only be used for shooting grouse. If you can't sort things out without suing someone or speaking to a therapist, then you're not ready to shoot grouse. Number 5. Therefore, you will no longer be allowed to own or carry anything more dangerous than a vegetable peeler. Although a permit will be required if you wish to carry a vegetable peeler in public. Number 6. All intersections will be replaced with roundabouts, and you will start driving on the left side with immediate effect. At the same time, you will go metric with immediate effect and without the benefit of conversion tables. Both roundabouts and metrication will help you understand the British sense of humor. Number 7. The former USA will adopt UK prices on petrol, which you have been calling gasoline, of roughly $10 a gallon. Get used to it. Number 8. You will learn to make real chips. Those things you call French fries are not real chips, and those things you insist on calling potato chips are properly called crisps. Real chips are thick-cut, fried in animal fat, and dressed not with ketchup, but with vinegar. Number 9. The cold, tasteless stuff you insist on calling beer is not actually beer at all. Henceforth, only proper British bitter will be referred to as beer, and European brews of known and accepted provenance will be referred to as lager. South African beer is also acceptable, as they are pound for pound, the greatest sporting nation on earth, and it can only be due to the beer. They are also a part of the British Commonwealth. See what it did for them. American brands will be referred to as near-frozen nuts urine so that all can be sold without risk of further confusion. Number 10. Hollywood will be required occasionally to cast English actors as good guys. Hollywood will also be required to cast English actors to play English characters. Watching Andy McDowell attempt English dialect in Four Weddings and a Funeral was an experience akin to having one's ears removed with a cheese grater. Number 11. You will cease playing American football. There is only one kind of proper football. You call it soccer. Those of you brave enough will in time be allowed to play rugby, which has some similarities to American football, but does not involve stopping for a rest every 20 seconds or wearing full Kevlar body armor like a bunch of Nazis. Number 12. Further, you will stop playing baseball. It is not reasonable to host an event called the World Series for a game which is not played outside of America. Since only 2.1% of you are aware there is a world beyond your borders, your error is understandable. You will learn cricket, and we will let you face the South Africans first to take the sting out of their deliveries. Number 13. You must tell us who killed JFK. It's been driving us mad. Number 14. An Internal Revenue Agent, i.e. tax collector, from Her Majesty's government will be with you shortly to ensure the acquisition of all monies due, backdated to 1776. Number 15. Daily tea time begins properly at 4 p.m. with proper cups, with sauces, and never mugs, with high-quality biscuits, cookies, and cakes, plus strawberries with cream when in season. God save the Queen!
This has been a parody of a speech written by Michael Young. If you would like to see more of my videos, please like, share, and subscribe to my video channel. Thank you for watching.